Sheriff Reed. What? How? I'm coming. I'll be right there.
Good Lord, when are we gonna take that thing down? A dream of seeing how nice that thing burns. I'd say...
Shut up! Now's not the time!
Just look at it. It's like it's tearing out my soul. But I'm not superstitious, not even a little. Mr. Nash, can we please take that thing down?
You live through the night, you can do whatever you want.
Well, finally. Tomorrow I'll get my...
Quiet! You hear that? Get in position.
580. have a visual.
Thank you.
580.
Thank you.
Roger.
Roger.
Target eliminated.
Thank you.
Can't talk. It's okay. You've already talked enough. I'm willing to bet, Colonel, that you're trying to figure out where you went wrong. And really, where? You're definitely not the stupidest criminal I've ever met. And all your, let's call them, philosophical reflections. You know what? There's something in them. Something true. Something that really gets me. I've had to deal with much more pretentious bastards than you. And even this plan of yours to wage an assault on the department. Was it crazy? Maybe. But again, it's not the craziest assault I've ever been a part of. A little more luck and it might have all worked out for you. So what's the problem? The problem is, Colonel, that you told everything, absolutely everything. All your thoughts, all your ideas, all your fucking plans, to the police chief. To the police chief! You must be completely nuts, right? Never played cops and robbers with your friends as a kid? It's a fun game, and the rules are very simple. The robbers are the bad guys, and the cops are the good guys. But don't worry, Colonel. I'll make sure that everyone here keeps choking down your smelly soup. For breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Get this trash out of my department.
Are you Mr. Fry?
Excuse me?
I asked, are you Mr. Fry?
Yeah, yes. Yes, I'm Mr. Fry. And you're from Mr. Nash, right?
That's right, from Mr. Nash. You know, we've been waiting for you for over an hour.
Yes, it's a shitty bus. You said you waited an hour? You must have some very warm jackets, guys. What do you say? You got an extra one for me?
Of course, Mr. Fry, of course. Let's get you into the car. We'll think of something.
Don't be offended, guys, but wow. You got yourselves a frozen cesspool out here.
Oh, we're not offended. Right, Jesse? We're not offended.
Not at all. It's true. We live in a shithole.
You should see our slaughterhouse.
Your slaughterhouse?
Sure, the slaughterhouse. Our mother always told us that if you want to know how clean the town is, you check how clean they keep their slaughterhouse.
How clean they keep their slaughterhouse?
Don't pay attention to my brother, Mr. Fry. It's just the kind of stuff we deal with out here.
That's right. Local jokes. Get on in, Mr. Fry. There's plenty of space in back.
What beautiful shoes you have, Mr. Fry. What a picture.
Says that when I want to try something new. I bought myself a tie. You look like a jerk in it. I thought about getting an earring in my ear. Only total jerks do that. You know, I did feel like a jerk when I first sat down on that thing. Then I got to thinking. It makes so much sense. Once everything is covered with snow, a snowmobile will come in pretty handy, right? I started it up, drove it around, and you know what? The real jerks are the ones who keep driving cars and riding bikes in this weather. That's what I think. And I keep thinking about that advertisement. All the roads opened before me. And it's true. I know, it sounds silly, but I swear, that's really how I felt. Like there were no more barriers. Like, I'm finally in control of this situation. You know the feeling, Mr. Nash?
Yeah, it's a great story, kid. The money's in the envelope, like always.
Hmm. Oh, by the way, those cigars you asked about earlier? Kings, right? Mr. Summers found a reliable supplier, but it'll still take at least a week, so I told him that you probably wouldn't want...
Caesars.
Excuse me?
Caesars. The cigars are called Caesars. Order them.
Oh, yes. Of course. Caesars. No problem, Mr. Nash. No problem. I just wanted to say that...
I don't care how long it takes. I'm not going anywhere. Emma, it's me.
Mr. Boyd? Mr. Boyd, oh, forgive me, Mr. Boyd.
Emma,
I'm sorry.
Emma, listen to me. Everything's fine. Lana made it. She's here.
Mr. Boyd, I couldn't help it. She
wants to help me, Emma. Do you hear me? Help me. Clear my name, you know? We already have... We have a plan, but we need your help. We need you to... Basically, you know, this isn't something we can talk about over the phone. Will you help me, Emma?
Mr. Boyd,
just come out here, Emma. Come out and we'll figure it out. You know where to find me. You know where to find me.
Of course, Mr. Boyd. Of course.
I'm counting on you, Emma.